Yes, my name is Rosalind Picard. I direct research in affective, with an A, computing at the MIT Media Lab. Affective computing is computing that relates to, arises from, or deliberately influences emotion. When I first proposed that we would look at emotion with an engineering hat on in a systematic, objective, measurable way, most people were pretty uncomfortable with the idea. Emotion was still believed to be something that made us irrational. It was believed to be something that was undesirable in day-to-day functioning. The less emotion, the better. So to come along and propose that we would actually deliberately understand, measure, and maybe even engineer some emotion into an interaction was not a welcome idea at the start. It took really a revolution in understanding what emotion is and what it does in our brains and how it is a part, a vital part, of each of our rational decisions. Not just of our human-human interaction, but of what makes us intelligent. As we understood that emotion contributes to intelligent functioning, people started to realize that we needed to engineer it better. There's several aspects of this. There is the aspect of the emotions that a person has in an interaction with technology. There are the aspects of emotion that people have with each other that they may or may not be aware of, and the technology that we wear or Skype through or talk through or communicate with may help mediate that affective communication. There are also the emotions that people aren't even aware are important in their day-to-day life. And those are, you know, deep in the brain, influencing and sending signals to every organ in the body, affecting our health. And we've been learning a lot more about all of these different kinds of emotion. This technology does have a new opportunity to give people feedback on what they are feeling, for many people who don't actually know what they're feeling, and for what they're expressing. Many times people might think, you know, I'm not angry, why do you think I'm angry? You know, and they look angry, maybe they have a headache and their corrugator, you know, looks really tight. The technology is measuring some things that have classically been used in lie detection also. Our lab has chosen to focus not on lie detection, but on affective states that people want to communicate and that are not currently successfully communicated. That said, some of the information can be used for sensing, you know, the veracity of what is going on inside a person. Our position in that technology and in all of our work has been to show respect for the user's feelings. When I envisioned affective computing in the beginning, it was to show respect for emotion. And that means throughout the process, whether it's choosing to put a sensor in, whether it's choosing to turn off a camera or turn on a microphone, whatever the opportunity is, the number one rule is first show respect for people's feelings in the situation.